how you develop the course for formwork, how you develop the course for reinforcement bar, and how you develop course for concrete works, and also the excavation works. Okay, so that is the unit cost. And what you have developed for your project too is the unit cost, and unit cost for each item of work in your BQ and in your BQ. So this topic is for estimation. So in overall project, so you need to be able to estimate the major element of a project, including the civil works lah, and including the civil works. So civil works yang dimasukkan dekat sini is the contohnya kerja-kerja projek bangunan, kan? For example, projek bangunan. So in the projek bangunan tu, they have the they call as M&E works. They have CNS work. They have architectural work, and all the infrastructure cost tu is you akan develop and from the previous data, and you can develop from the previous data. So dia ada peringkat, they have a stages of estimation process, and since the inception. So maksudnya, in order for you to orang kata to achieve the cost tu, and sampailah ke dia panggil post estimation cost. So dia ada peringkat-peringkat dia ada level of estimation dia, kan? Maksudnya sebelum perancangan dia ada cost dia masing-masing. So this is orang kata the topic of estimation of overall project and of overall project. Okay, so what is the estimation definition? Okay, so you need the definition is to judge and decide the value of the project, to judge and decide the value of the project. Okay, so meaning that the cost of major component of the project too, you need to judge and what are the value or size of the cost of the project, and so that you can decide, and as katakan you as a client, and you the client, you nak decide sama ada nak teruskan project ni ke tak, and you nak decide. You want to see the dia panggil what is your dia panggil ROI lah, return of investment. If you spend banyak ni, and if you spend katakan 1 million for this project, so what are you expect to get this ROI and return of investment, and as a client lah, as a client. And kalau it depend on the type of client, it depend on the type of client. Okay, so tadi ada student nak masuk? Ada. Okay, so and then to forecast what job or service is expected to cost, and of course in every project, and in every project, so they have a lot of service yang nak dibuat, and maksudnya yang is subjected to the overall cost of the project. And contohnya kalau projek bangunan tu memang dia ada cost for including the maintenance and also all the necessary item untuk bangunan tu lah. And for the major part is you need to be able to estimate the cost for infra cost. You need to be able to, dia panggil infra cost lah. Infra cost. And then ni termasuklah all the civil works, termasuk water recirculation and so on, and then M&E works, maksudnya M&E works ni termasuk all the vertical transportation system, all the electrical works and so on. Okay, and then the architectural part is for finishing punya part lah, and of course all this is the construction cost. All this is the construction cost. Maksudnya yang melibatkan the construction, yang melibatkan you kira all the quantities and all the labor rate and so on, and then you combine, dia akan jadi the unit rate lah, dia akan jadi the unit rate. And then of course the cost of designing this orang kata infra MNE and architecture, dia mesti ada professional fees and professional fees and cost of supervision dan sebagainya. Okay, so so you need to focus what are the job and service expected to cost. So that's why they came the orang kata the estimation punya definition lah, kan. Okay, so important of estimating. So the purpose of estimating is to provide the most realistic prediction. Okay, so what is the most realistic prediction? Of course, when you want to do the project, you must be able to identify what are the latest and the latest price lah, and the latest price, the latest price untuk tempat tu, kan? Untuk sesuatu tempat. Kalau you nak buat project dekat Malaysia, you need to be able to know what are the latest price. So that's why apa nama, dekat Malaysia ni kita ada Royal Institutions of Surveyor Malaysia. So and then all the parties yang terlibat dalam sektor industri ni, contohnya CIDB and also apa nama dipanggil, all the industry player punya persatuan, kan. So selalunya at the end of the year dia akan keluarkan buku, dia panggil construction cost, kan. So that construction cost tu you boleh refer, kan. So all the latest material price for that particular years, dia akan keluarkan the cost tu. Dia akan keluarkan the cost tu. Okay, and then bersama-sama dengan mengikut dia punya price range, mengikut dia punya meter square, meter cube dan sebagainya. So that's why you need to provide the most realistic prediction and possible of time cost of the project. Then of the project, maksudnya if you nak buat project tu in 5 years later, so you need to multiply and by the inflation cost and so on. And maksudnya you merancang project tu pada tahun 2021. Okay, merancang project tu pada tahun 2021, and then you nak buat that project in 2023. So the cost yang you all will refer to is the latest cost lah, is 2021 lah, but you need to multiply with the inflation cost and so on. Okay, so so that akan membuatkan you punya orang kata estimation tu the most realistic prediction lah, and the most realistic prediction termasuk all the latest cost. Okay, ada siapa lagi nak masuk? Okay, next, to determine the viability of the project, and viability means that if you are the client, then you refer balik kepada kita punya lecture in our first 2 weeks dulu, kan. So the entire project life cycle, they start dengan conceptual stage, and conceptual stage, and then engineering and design. Okay, refer balik the first two lecture, engineering and design, and then procurement, and then construction and operation. Okay, this is the project life cycle, dia panggil project life cycle. So when you want to determine the viability of the project, okay, so you need to be able to know what are the cost lah, and especially the cost tu, and what are the turnover ratio, and what are the turnover ratio untuk project tersebut. And of course the project is, kita tak lari daripada this triple constraint lah, and the triple constraint of the project is the cost, time and quality. And so when we talk about estimating, it's all about the cost lah, kan. It's all about the cost, and then semua ni they relate, time and quality is also relate to the cost, and is relate to the cost. If you punya project want to use the lousy spec of maksudnya the lousy quality of apa nama material, so they can impact in term of cost. And of course the viability ni is very important, sama ada nak teruskan project ataupun tak, kan. Of course it based on the client punya budget and requirement juga, kan, client punya budget, kan, budget and meet the requirement, and then also the meet the requirement by local authority and so on lah, kan. So that is nak tengok sama ada projek tu viable or not to untuk teruskan projek tu, nak tengok what the viability of the project. So to make the further decisions of the proposed project. Okay, so further decisions maksudnya sama ada dia nak teruskan ke tak, kan, adakah projek tu berbaloi untuk dilaksanakan, kan. It give the clear picture of the project of the expenditure of the proposed project. So when you do the estimating, so they have the stages of cost lah, the stages of cost. So you akan tengok cost for construction, how much is the cost for construction, how much the cost for professional fees and so on, and how much the cost for maintenance and so on. So the overall picture of you punya project ni, okay, you akan dapat the clear picture in term of cost lah, kan. You nak buat decisions, and as a client ataupun as the project owner, you nak buat decisions, decision making, you need to have the data, and one of the most important data is the cost lah, and the cost. Okay, so provide means which actual cost may be compared to the estimated cost. So actual cost dia selalunya it not going to be the same, kan. So maybe you estimate cost of this project maybe 100 million, so it can shoot up to 200 million based on the apa nama, based on you punya project requirement, maksudnya from time to time. And sometimes the cost they panggil the additional cost ni because of the additional requirement by the local authority ataupun by by you jugalah, and by you as a client, maksudnya dia nak project tu lebih in term of spec and the quality. So they can reflect to the cost lah, and to the cost. So maybe you punya estimated cost and it's not the same as the actual cost, kan. So dia ada banyak faktor-faktor yang terlibat lah, kan, yang terlibat. So what are the objective of the estimation? Okay, so give the prior indication of the economic viability. So and when we talk about cost ni, mestilah kita kaitkan dengan dia punya economic viability. And when you want to do the one new project, kan, katakan tahun 2021, kan, 2021 or 2022. So with the economic slowdown, so what are the economic viability for that particular project? Adakah viable untuk buat projek perumahan pada tahun ni, kan? So in the near future, adakah what are the economic factor yang contribute, kan, to the inflation, to the GDP and so on. So and based on the cost yang you estimate ni, so it give the prior indication, and before you nak make a decisions, they make the clear indication and what are the ROI dan sebagainya lah. Okay, it help to establish data, and data cost ni is very important lah, kan, for any project. Dan nanti saya tunjuk dekat you the construction cost data. Okay, and then maksudnya when you develop the cost ni, kan, the cost sama ada the detail cost ataupun the rough estimated cost, so you boleh dapatkan dia punya the prior indication tu lah, kan. So help the new design to reduce the cost when the original design is found uneconomical. So maksudnya when you dah siapkan satu project, the previous project, you have the data for that particular project, you have the dia panggil achieve cost, and the achieve cost maksudnya selepas project tu hand over to the client, you get the achieve cost tu. So when you get the achieve cost tu, okay, maybe you want to reduce some cost, kan. So you want to omit something, so you can use the, apa nama, the previous data tu. So that previous data tu you can use to omit, and what are the design yang you rasakan is not necessary for apa nama, for the new project lah kan. So it improve the design based on the design data for that found and uneconomical. Okay, so better decisions, and better decisions can be made whether to proceed the project or not. Yeah. So kita tengok okay, this is the data yang dikeluarkan oleh slow. Okay, yang dikeluarkan oleh Building Cost Information Service Malaysia dan Cost Book 2021. Okay, by CIDB Malaysia and Royal Institution of Surveyor Malaysia. Okay, so when you look at this, so they have a lot of data, and they have a lot of data. Okay, so especially for surveyor lah kan, who want to estimate the cost kan, the detail cost ke, sama ada you nak produce a detail cost, you nak masukkan dekat dalam BQ, or the rough estimated cost. So you can refer to this latest data. And for example, katakan you want to build the estimate cost for prior indication kan. So you boleh ambil dia punya cost untuk tahun 2020 ni, and they based on the previous years lah. And contohnya you nak buat light duty factories, okay, so dia punya what are the gross floor area. So bila you tahu dia punya gross floor area, so you boleh multiply by RM. Katakan you ambil tengah-tengah, and you ambil average for this range 1380 and 1380 to 1005 per meter square. Katakan your light duty factories tu is 1000 meter square, so you just multiply by 1500, so you get the rough estimate of your project, and of your project, of total cost of your project. So this is the building price. So dia ada lagi the data for it mengikut for mechanical and electrical price. So they have the data in RM per meter square. So they give the apa nama, they give this apa nama, okay, so the data is in RM per meter square. Okay, what else? Hari tu ada yang tanya berkenaan dengan unit. You develop that unit cost for excavation, for hardcore bed, for lean concrete, and actually semua tu is being estimate by our Royal Institution of Surveyor Malaysia lah. And but in our syllabus, you nak kena buat sendiri. So that's why the last week kita dah tengok how to develop the cost for estimation, how to develop cost for excavation, for lean concrete, for mild steel height. Okay, so you develop the cost ni, and you develop ni the cost. So that's how they do it. And so dengan mengambil kira the cost of labor, and the output of labor, the cost of reinforcement bar per ton dan sebagainya. Kan? Okay. So ada masalah tak berkenaan dengan unit rate yang you all develop last week?
So far okay, cuma yang steel tu macam ni lah, buat average lah macam ni.
Yes. Maksudnya you tengok you punya project tu, maksudnya you punya drawing. So based on you punya katakan you punya two story building tu, they have the range between T12 sampai T16. So you just ambil satu value lah, and to develop the cost for mild steel ni. To develop the cost for mild steel, you ambil satu value for main bar, satu value for stirrup. Okay, so maksudnya when you want to develop the reinforcement bar punya cost, so you ada dua cost lah, satu for the main bar, satu for stirrup. And stirrup selalunya dia punya diameter is below than 8 mm and below than 8 mm, so maybe lesser lah compare to the main bar lah. And so maybe you akan ambil the average punya price. Okay. Ada apa-apa masalah berkenaan dengan nak develop the unit ni? Dan tadi you tanya pasal high tensile reinforcement bar.
So ini boleh jadikan macam rujukan lah, sir. Maksud kalau
yes, kita yes.
Buat tu lari sangat kan?
Boleh. Yang ni, yang ni data ni tahun 2020 punya data. And okay, they develop this year. And they develop this course this year. You bolehlah ambil sebagai ni. Tapi saya nak you develop by your own according to the apa nama previous lecture lah, and not just ambil directly daripada sini. Sebab tu saya tak bagi ni last week. Kalau saya bagi ni last week, maybe you just ambil direct from this table. So you need to develop you punya own course lah, kan? So bila you dah develop you punya own course dengan mengambil kira output of the labor and material price, and material price harga reinforcement bar sekarang berapa, so you alert and what are the latest price for construction material lah. Okay, so this is the price actually, and the price untuk OPC sekarang ni RM15.40. So you boleh ambil item-item ni lah, and untuk you develop you punya cost. Kalau dah buat tu tak ada masalah, you kekalkan dengan you punya cost, kan? So okay. cuma yang ni saya nak bagi yang the latest one lah, kan? The latest one.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, so that is the data from construction cost data lah, kan? Yang after this saya akan masukkan dekat Google Classroom. Okay, so kita tengok pula the stages of estimating. The stages of estimating. So for the stages of estimating ni dia ada banyak peringkat lah, kan? Macam saya cerita tadi, kan? So the first stage is called as a preliminary estimates. So the preliminary estimate ni is based on the previous data. For example, you akan ambil the data contohnya mengikut gross. Okay. Kan? Gross floor area in meter square. Kan? So you tengok tadi you nak ambil untuk nak buat apa nama light duty punya factory, harga dia and 1500 RM, 1500 per meter square. So you maybe you boleh ambil this as your indicator, kan? Tengok how big is your factory is, and then you develop the cost. You just estimate the cost, rough estimate, kan? Okay. And then appraisal stage, and then the panggil a proposal estimate lah, kan? The proposal estimate, and then the approved estimate, pre-tender estimate, and the achieved cost. Okay, this is the stages of estimating. The stages of estimating. Dia sama juga dengan kalau you nak relate dengan dipanggil a project life cycle. So this appraisal, proposal, approved estimate, pre-tender estimate, and achieved cost ni is relate to the project life cycle juga. Project life cycle sampailah ke operation and maintenance. Okay, sampailah ke operation and maintenance. So for the preliminary cost, and for the preliminary cost, and they use the maybe they akan ambil yang paling latest lah, data yang paling latest. Katakan you nak develop project tu in 3 years time. So you pakai data pada tahun ni lah, kan, the latest price ataupun the previous 3 years and below lah, kan? Okay, and then if data tak ada, maybe you pakai yang 10 tahun yang lepas, then you need to multiply by the economic factors and the inflation, kan? So dalam construction cost punya guideline tadi tu, dia ada deflation inflation rate. So you boleh multiply by the inflation rate, and so that you get the orang kata the good estimate lah, and dia tak lari jauh lah. Okay, so the preliminary estimating an initial estimate at the earliest possible stage, okay, based on the indication of the project size, and dia tengok the project size and jenis size, the jenis project tu jenis apa. And katakan you nak buat high-rise building, so you tengok dekat high-rise building punya price, and then what are the capacity of that project. And okay, so daripada situ you boleh dapatkan the rough estimate ataupun preliminary estimate to orang kata untuk nak convincekan you punya client. And kalau kata you architect, you nak buat proposal dekat you punya client, so you boleh gunakan this data lah kan, and this data, dan dapatlah apa nama orang kata satu solid punya data untuk di present to your client. Yeah. Okay, so the appraisal estimate, okay, the appraisal estimate should include all the costs which charge against the project, and in order to provide the best estimate in anticipated of the total cost, and cost utama, kan? Dia panggil the cost utama lah, and cost utama dalam projek tersebut termasuk the professional fees for engineering work selalunya lah, and 1.5% to 2%, and JKR project tinggi sikit lah kan, JKR project 3%, okay sikit lah siapa dapat projek for professional fee for engineering project, for engineering fee, and for CNS, for mechanical and so on. Okay, so that is the latest fee, professional fee. And compared to architect boleh pergi sampai 5 to 10%, and that is the professional fee, panggil professional fee yang client bayar kepada consultant yang terlibat dalam projek untuk produce apa nama dia punya design lah. And okay, and then this is the cost utama lah, and professional fee, and then construction cost, how much the construction cost, and construction cost. Okay, so the operation and the maintenance cost for 1 or 2 years before handover 100% to the client, and dia panggil operation and maintenance. Okay, so benda ni you just estimate roughly based on the previous data tu lah. And but cost utama ni you need to tabulate dan mengikut dia punya kategori, and mengikut kategori of professional cost, construction cost, dan operation and maintenance. And okay, so the proposal estimate, so selepas you dah buat all the necessary apa nama estimate yang di peringkat awal tadi tu, and di peringkat awal tadi tu yang you dah keluarkan all the professional fee punya cost, all the construction cost, dan based on the cost yang you dah design tu, and based on you punya design tu, so you akan buat the still in the proposal estimating, then still in the proposal estimating cost. Okay, so for this proposal estimate ni, so you nak present to the client, kan, sama ada design yang you pakai tu adakah client bersetuju, kan. Sebelum ni pun you dah present ni mungkin kali ketiga dan keempat, kan, and for the third and fourth time, and so you present. Kali ni you dah ada the detail design juga, kan, termasuk the concept design and so on. Okay, termasuk dia punya cost. Okay, you nak present to the client ataupun to the funder lah. Okay. So for approved estimate, so apabila client tu dah bersetuju ataupun the project funder tu dah bersetuju dengan you punya concept design, termasuk you in engineering aspect and so on, and material apa nak pakai, and secara draft. Okay, so give the proposal estimate. Maybe dia akan modify a bit based on the client punya view lah, kan. So client ni dia ada banyak, mungkin project tu berkait dengan government sector, so dia ada dia punya tata cara government punya project lah. And for the private sector, kan, dia ada dia punya tata cara sendiri lah kan. Maksudnya dia kena present to dia punya stakeholders and dia kena present dekat dia punya board of director sebelum nak approve untuk menjalankan projek tu kan. And then of course kalau individual client ni more easier than private or government sector lah kan, so that dia terus direct kepada client view saja kan. So kalau individual client is lebih mudah lah compared to the private and the government sector, which they can apa nama nak kena ada peringkat apa nama approved by dia punya stakeholders and so on. Okay. And then the pre-tender estimate, okay, based on the agreed design tu, the of course they need to meet the client punya requirement lah. And client punya requirement, katakan client punya requirement dia nak bangunan tu berkonsepkan apa, nak berkonsepkan green building and so on. So apabila dia dah meet the client requirement and then meet the client budget juga lah. And of course client tu must have budget. So they go for pre-tender estimate. So this pre-tender estimate ni dia dah nak buat tender lah kan. Maksudnya all the design in term of architecture dah siap and all the engineering aspect pun dah siap. So dia nak go for pre-tender kan. So at this stage and engineering and design pun dah siap, dia nak go for tender kan, nak go for tender. So last dia akan buat a refinement of the approved estimate based on the definitive design using the information provided in the tender document. So in your tender document tu, yang tu yang you buat process of taking off kan. In your project tu and in your BQ project, you buat taking off, you take all the element daripada engineering aspect and also the architectural aspect, you calculate all the quantity, then quantity of concrete, quantity of formwork, reinforcement bar, and quantity of facade system and per meter square, per meter cube dan sebagainya. So you nak produce a tender document. Then you nak produce the tender document. Okay, so at this stage the estimator should reflect the total cost of the project and charge the fee and allowance and all contingency and for the client risk. So at this stage dia dah go for detail lah kan. So bila you dah dapat kan, this is orang kata QS punya peranan lah kan, quantity surveyor punya job, which is dia akan masukkan all the rate, the latest price untuk projek ni secara detail dan mengikut elemen-elemen yang telah didesain oleh architect and engineers kan. Okay, and then the post contract, and post contract tu maksudnya selepas tender tu telah di, after the tender has been awarded to the contractor kan. So peringkat pre-tender ni maksudnya you dah siapkan the tender tu sebelum you nak pilih who is the winning contractor, and the winning contractor akan buy this tender document, then dia akan quote the price. And you as a QS for client, you ada you punya own price. And then when you have your own price, so you buatlah process of evaluating this tender. And katakan tender came from 10 contractor. And 10 contractors. So you evaluate all these tender, and then you list down top three bidder yang meet the requirement by the client, and then you select the lowest tender lah, and then you apa nama bagi project tu kepada this winning contractor. Okay, so the winning contractor akan buat project tu, execute the project, maksudnya in physical. And so based on this stage akan berlaku apa nama claim lah, akan berlaku proses claim. So claim ni is based on the BQ untuk project tersebut lah, and BQ untuk project tersebut. Okay, so if let's say and semasa construction stage tu being executed, so other changes, and they have a changes in design. So whenever have a changes in design, so there is a additional cost lah. Kalau kata apa nama changes tu is made by the client itself. So client must apa nama pay the additional cost akan diklaim oleh pihak contractor. Or maybe omission, kan? Dia ada pengurangan kos, kan? Maybe omit the design tu. So that is the post contract estimating. Okay. So the achieved cost is the total the actual cost on the job in order to review the performance and data and provide the data for future project. So maksudnya this is you punya tender you punya contract cost asal, katakan for example 100 million and contract asal 100 million. Okay, so achieved cost means that after the completion of the project, then all the orang kata spec or the requirement by client you dah meet dan you dah construct secara physical, so you achieve cost. Achieve cost katakan RM 120 million. Kan? So dah di pay pun, dah di claim pun oleh this contractor. Kan? So achieve cost, total cost, the final account is 120 million. So this is the achieve cost untuk project tersebut. And this is the achieve cost. This is termasuklah all the variation order, all the omission, all the orang kata necessary item to construct the project lah. And termasuklah all the apa nama prime cost item, provisional sum dan sebagainya. And apa nama, katakan you nak in order to complete the project, you ada process of version of road lah, dan nak ubah apa nama kedudukan lighting pole asal, nak ubah dia nak ubah balik ke tempat asal dan sebagainya. Okay, so the achieved cost is 120 million. So this 120 million ni lah which is digunakan untuk sebagai basis untuk for the future project, kan? Okay. Okay, so far any question for stages of estimating before we go next
item? Tak ada.
Okay.
Okay. Alright.
Okay. So this is the type of estimating techniques yang common techniques lah yang digunakan. You boleh tengok tadi the stages of estimating tadi, kan? Di peringkat awal from the appraisal estimating cost sampailah to the achieve cost. So dia ada dah teknik-teknik yang digunakan yang bersesuaian. And for example, untuk mendapatkan untuk dapatkan the approval by the client ataupun by the apa nama funder untuk satu-satu project, and to get the fastest rate ataupun the fastest cost untuk project tu, maybe you can use the global technique. And global technique is a simple estimating technique which based on the existing data from the similar project. And so you tengok the construction cost book tadi tu, kan? So katakan you nak apa nama nak buat project the new two story building. So you tengok the item for two story building, and what is the price for in meter square. So that data you boleh multiply by certain factor lah, kan? Contohnya kalau you pakai the factorial technique ni, so you may multiply by time factor, kan? Maksudnya kalau ada perubahan design, so you multiply by the design factor, and then you dapatlah cost yang you nak buat estimating tu, kan? Di peringkat awal, kan? So factorial ni dia a technique used widely on the process where the key component can be easily identified and priced, and all the works are calculated based on the factor and factor time and time factor, design factor and so on. And katakan you want to build project bangunan sekolah, katakan government project lah, kan? Government project bangunan sekolah Kementerian Pelajaran Malaysia. Okay, so JKR dia dah ada dia punya standard design untuk projek sekolah ni, kan? Untuk projek sekolah. So standard design tu dia apply untuk tahun, katakan tahun 2015 sampai 2020. So you nak buat projek tu in 2020. Okay, so you boleh ambil data from 2015 tu, kan? You ambil data tersebut dan you multiply by the total cost, you nak ambil the total cost, you multiply by the time factor, and time factor tu maybe dia punya increase, and by year dia increase 2% per year, so you multiply lah 2% per year, and then some additional of the design factor, some additional for design factor, they increase berapa persen, and maybe the latest requirement of Kementerian Pelajaran Malaysia nak kena tambah the design of the school tu, nak kena lebarkan dia punya width of the width of the kelebaran classroom dan sebagainya lah. So that is about the design factor. So you multiply all these factors, so you dapat rough figure for untuk develop the cost untuk projek tersebut. Okay. So usually these two global and factorial ni banyak digunakan di peringkat awal lah, di peringkat awal. Okay. So another techniques untuk develop the cost, contohnya based on the operational. So based on the operational ni dia dah go detail. So you dah ada design, and you already have the design, architectural design and also civil and structural design. So you can take all the works related to that particular works. Contohnya kerja-kerja konkrit. So kerja-kerja konkrit dia melibatkan the labor, melibatkan plan, melibatkan material. Okay. So kerja-kerja konkrit dia melibatkan nak dapatkan the concrete itself lah, harga konkrit. Harga konkrit sekarang ni katakan 200 grade 20. And then harga plan apa yang nak digunakan. And katakan for example you nak pour the concrete using the crane. And crane dia sewa sehari katakan 400 per day. And okay, this is the cost of the plan. And then cost of the labor. Cost of the labor. General labor you bayar berapa? And general labor katakan you bayar RM15 per day. So all this, you combine all this general cost of labor and cost of material and cost of crane dan sebagainya, you akan develop the cost of operational tu, and dalam dalam unit rate lah, and dia panggil method related charge, and method related charge yang saya bagi example tadi is cost untuk kerja-kerja konkret. Kerja-kerja reinforcement bar, so you kena tengok pula what are the kerja-kerja reinforcement bar. Yeah. Okay, so man hour and unit rate ni, okay, contohnya man hour. So man hour ni selalunya kita akan tengok the output of the labor itself, and output of the labor. And dalam masa sejam dia boleh dia boleh buat excavation katakan 1 meter cube, kan. So that is the man hour. Work is estimated on the total man hour and cost in conjunction with the plan and material cost. Okay, so man hour ni juga, kan, you can use as katakan you as the contractor, you nak bayar you punya pekerja, kan, you nak pay your monthly salary for your workers lah. So you boleh tanda dekat dia punya kalau dalam bahasa site dia bagi kongkat lah, kongkat. So you boleh verify and how many hour that the general workers works. And so you boleh gunakan juga teknik ni untuk dapatkan nak bayar cost of you punya labor. Okay. Last is you develop the unit rate. So the unit rate ni of course it based on the bill of quantity. And katakan you dah dapatkan the quantity for reinforcement bar in kg. Quantity for reinforcement bar in kg. So you nak develop the cost block, of course lah, in RM per kg. So this is the unit cost yang dikatakan. And okay. So usually kita akan pakai the technique of method related charge for each of the item of work untuk develop the unit cost untuk bill of quantity. And macam saya ajar previous week lah. And last week kita dah tengok how to develop the cost untuk kerja-kerja formwork, reinforcement bar, excavation kan, dan concrete. Okay, so whenever you nak put your price in the bill of quantity, so of course you need to see the standard method of measurement juga lah. Standard method of measurement ni, and usually they mention about the rule of measurement tu, and they mention about the rule of measurement, and also the work to what works to be covered in one discussion item of work tu. Kan? So you buat project you nampak kan, and discussion item of work tu contohnya supply, katakan item konkrit tu dia kata supply grade 20 JKR mix concrete pour and vibrate the concrete at slab and at slab. So, maksudnya you need to develop the cost termasuk supply of the concrete, termasuk you nak kena pour the concrete, termasuklah you nak vibrate the concrete tersebut and di dalam formwork. And so that is the works dia panggil method related charge. And so method related charge yang kita nak develop ni is based on the standard method of measurement punya principle lah. The standard method of measurement, katakan you pakai SMM2. And SMM2 maybe dia tak sama dengan MySism. And MySism dia bukan tak sama secara 100%. Maksudnya in term of dia punya unit of measurement and rule of measurement tu. And okay, so as you know, SMM2 sesuai digunakan untuk project building project. For SISM, dia lebih sesuai untuk infrastructure project. So kedua-duanya ada kelebihan masing-masing lah. Okay, so the constituents of estimating, I think previous week kita dah tengok what are the constituents of estimating to develop the unit cost tu, kan? Katakan you nak develop the cost of reinforcement bar in kg, kan? So reinforcement bar in kg, kan? So you need to be able to identify the labor output, kan? Labor output untuk kerja-kerja fixing, nak cut and bend the reinforcement bar, kan? So the cost of labor ni, okay, is very important lah, kan? It's very important to develop you punya output, kan? To develop you punya output, okay? Of course they based on the skill juga, and they based on the skill, okay? The skill, skill labor or general labor. So the man hour dia tak sama, kita bayar dia pun tak sama, okay? Cost of tool and plant, and cost of tool and plant, and the cost should include the initial cost of the machine. Okay, this is if you buy the machine lah, and if you rent, you just masukkan cost of rent per day, and then you convert lah per hour, and then you relate dah dengan dia punya, and relate lah dengan dia punya output. Yang penting for the tool and plant ni dia punya output, kan? For example, untuk excavator, do the excavation work 8 meter cube per day. And so you akan dapatkan dia punya output, kan? And then you translate into RM per meter cube, katakan untuk kerja-kerja excavation, kan? Seperti mana yang saya tunjuk last week. Okay. And then cost of material. And cost of material, you may use the latest price of material, kan? Material untuk ordinary Portland cement, kan? Material for concrete, katakan you buy the ready mix concrete, kan? Ready mix concrete for grade 20 tak sama dengan price the ready mix concrete for grade 30, kan? So that is the material price that you must include to allow the stage and also the delivery to site, kan? So of course, bila you dah develop all the item ni, kan, of course you need to multiply by your profit lah, kan? As contractor ataupun as a client, you mesti allow for contractor to make profit, kan? So profit selalunya between 15% to 20%. So that's why in every calculation yang kita dah tengok before this, I always multiply by 1.15. So saya ambil yang the lowest punya profit lah, kan? Sebab kita dah dapatkan cost of the labor, cost of tool and plant, and then cost of material, and then you need to multiply lastly by 1.15 because of 15% the profit margin. Okay, so any question for this estimation?
Nak tanya sikit pasal yang teknik estimate tu.
Okay.
Boleh tak kalau macam contoh kita masuk kerja,
Okay.
Lepas tu kita punya harga kerja kita tu, kalau dalam dia keluar senarai tu, kita dapat nombor, kita punya harga kerja tu nombor 10. So untuk
Okay.
next project yang similar, similar punya tajuk dia, kita gunakan kontraktor yang menang, yang dapat nombor 1, 2, 3 tu sebagai rujukan kita untuk buat estimate next project. Yang tu kira boleh guna teknik tu.
Okay, you as a client or you as a contractor?
As a contractor lah, kita nak masuk kerja.
Okay.
So bila kita dah ni kan.
Okay, selalunya kan, as a client, katakan you as a client. As a client, you akan pilih kan, you akan choose the top 3, katakan top 3 yang bagi harga yang within you punya range. Within you punya range. Within you punya range ni maksudnya tak tinggi sangat, tak rendah sangat. Kan? So ada 3 saja yang masuk. Kalau ada 10, 10 lah dia akan tengok another item. Okay. Katakan ada 3 je masuk dalam range ni. Dalam range between katakan projek tu bernilai 90 juta. So ada orang masuk 100 juta, ada orang masuk 90 juta. So between this range saja yang diterima. So ada 3 contractor je bid for this range of price. Okay. So another item yang nak dilihat oleh client ni is you punya track record lah. Of course you punya track record. Katakan ada 3 orang ni and you punya track record of you punya previous project. And then adalah lagi dia punya item-item yang red, yang orang kata yang apa nama akan dipilih kan. Selalunya benda ni is very subjective for the client lah. And as you as a contractor pula, and you as a contractor, so that's why apa nama client ni actually dia tak boleh nak bocorkan rahsia harga dia cap berapa kan, dia cap pun. Kalau dia bocorkan harga tu maksudnya dia tak jujur dalam melaksanakan amanah dia lah kan. So that's why apabila you develop the cost yang you pakai the operation ataupun method related charge yang you based on the latest price. This is the latest price 2021. So bila you develop cost tu, dia selalunya dia mesti akan achieve the cost tu lah. Maksudnya dia akan sampai ke cost-cost yang terlibat. Because you as, katakan you sebagai contractor yang ada knowledge pasal benda ni, pasal nak develop the unit cost using method related charge. And client pun menggunakan data yang sama. Client punya QS pun dia akan gunakan benda yang sama. Of course dia tak bagi data yang dia buat dekat you, tapi kalau you guna pakai the latest price ni, you akan ambil the latest price ni. So you punya tendency untuk you bid untuk dapatkan top 3 tu akan jadi lebih tinggi. Maksudnya dia possibility to get untuk dapatkan top 3 punya apa nama dapatkan projek tu lebih tinggi lah kan, berbanding dengan orang yang maksudnya kontraktor yang tak ada knowledge pasal method related charge menggunakan the latest price ni kan, the latest price. So kalau you tengok dekat sini all the item the latest price termasuk all the material and then the forecast for tender price semua ada dekat sini kan, the tender price and then tengok dia punya percentage of change. So semua ada dekat sini. So as a contractor yang knowledgeable, so you boleh ambil item-item ni dan you develop your own cost before you nak quote the price. And sebab client pun akan refer benda yang sama. And dia akan refer benda yang sama lah and to develop their own.
Oh, so benda ni pun dah cukup lah untuk kita buat.
Yes. Kalau you nak bid for the project lah kan. And then lagi satu dia adalah teknik yang ni is very hard lah kan. Kalau projek untuk JKR dia of course dia pakai yang higher price compare to the private sector ni kalau boleh dia nak rendah lagi. So that is my experience sebelum ni. So kalau boleh dia nak tekan you sehabis rendah you punya price. Sometimes kalau you punya as a CNS punya consultant and you punya rate you katakan 1.5 and you cap for 1.5, kadang-kadang dia boleh rendahkan you punya fee dan sampailah ke 0.8. kan, 0.8 price, maksudnya professional fee tu, katakan total cost of the project is 100 million, so you just dapat 0.8% of you punya cost, you punya keuntungan, man, as consultant. Kan, disebabkan tak ada projek, ambil jugalah. Kan, disebabkan tak ada projek, ambil juga. So kalau kata you bid for government project they must comply to the regulation. Sebab tu orang ke as a CNS consultant ni, dia selalunya nak go for government project. 3% is 3% lah, 3% is 3%. So dia takkan rendahkan dia punya cap price tu. Yeah. Especially kita lah as a CNS consultant ni, architect fee dia tinggi. Yeah. Architect memang fee tinggi compared to CNS. Yeah. Sedih sikit lah CNS. Okay, so that is the apa nama, the latest price. Nanti saya akan masukkan dekat Google Classroom. But dalam you punya BQ project, you jangan ambil sebiji macam ni. You need to develop by your own. Kan? Sebab tu kita ajar you how to develop your cost. Okay, so kalau you tengok